big room full of bad.
What's up? It's Kreayshawn. You are watching SoulCulture TV. Yeah.
One big room full of bad. One big room full of bad.
You know, when people say, you know, oh, it's a gimmick, oh, it's like a viral video thing, you know, it's definitely not that, because, you know, it is one of the only music things that have crossed over from being a viral video to going to radio to being mainstream to getting me signed, you know what I'm saying? So I wouldn't say it's a gimmick at all, because if it was a gimmick, it wouldn't have gone this far, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, if anything, it just puts a lot of pressure, not pressure, but it gives me more motivation to finish my album, to prove to everyone that, like, this isn't a gimmick, you know what I'm saying? Everyone has the chance to make a video and put it online and have it go where my video went, you know? It's just all about pushing yourself. For every one hater, there's like 1,000 people who are like in love with me, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, of course, like, the hate is just like stuff you read and then you're kind of like, that's whack, you know? But then you read the next thing and it's just like, I love Kreayshawn so much. She inspires me to do film. She inspires me to do music. She inspires me to like wear whatever I want to wear and just be comfortable in my own skin. And that's really like what I like to do, is just like use my voice and my star power to like make people feel better about themselves, or make people feel like they can do something that they didn't feel like was possible before. Because putting out Gucci Gucci online, I wasn't thinking like I'm gonna get a record deal. Like, I never even thought of anything like that before. So, you know, everything's possible. I mean, definitely that day when I posted that was like a rough day for me, because like everything like basically went wrong within 24 hours. So like, just like any other person, I'm gonna have like a whole bunch of stuff on my mind and freak out, and myself, I overanalyze anyway. So when I did that blog post, you know, like everything I said was true in it, but it's not exactly how I feel every day, you know what I'm saying? It was definitely reflective of like how I just felt at that moment, you know what I'm saying? But, you know, when I came into the game, you know, I didn't really know what to expect, and that's the thing that sometimes like gets me confused, because, you know, you don't know what you're getting into, really. You see what's going on TV and stuff like that, but you never see like the behind the scenes and what it takes to promote a single, and all the stuff you have to do, and all the photo shoots and interviews and stuff like that. But, you know, like, it's definitely exciting to go through this, and you learn a lot about yourself in the process of everything.
One big room full of bad. One big room full of bad.
I definitely learned a good lesson on just like, you know, because what I said about him wasn't like, and it, you know, like, I don't have any problem with him, you know what I'm saying? Like, I've listened to his music, like, you know, he's Rick Ross, he's a boss, you know what I'm saying? So like, I never had a problem with him, and it's just basically me goofing off with my friends and taking it too far. And if I was nobody, it wouldn't even have mattered. But now that I have the star power, you know what I'm saying, like, it's a big deal. So, you know, it's definitely taught me to like watch what I'm saying at certain times, you know, especially saying stuff that you don't really mean, just to like joke off with your friends. So, you know, like, you know, every day is learning. It's a learning process, and, you know, everything happens really fast. So, you know, it's definitely quick learning, you know. No, I mean now she kind of tries to chime in, but I would tell her, Mom, that was like 20 years ago, you know what I'm saying? Like, things have definitely changed. I'm not in a surf punk band right now. I'm making rap music, you know what I'm saying? So, you know, she's always trying to give me advice, and you know, she always gets really worried about stuff that she shouldn't even be getting worried about, and like, you know, it's hard for her to understand what's going on, but she's there for me. She tries.
So like, where do you take your leads from, or your, you know, like, obviously her experience has been different to yours, so you know, you can take advice with a pinch of salt, but who really helps guide you?
I just have to say, you know, trusting my own instincts, and, you know, anything that I feel might be questionable, you know, I just ask my manager, you know, either before I tweet it or before I say it, you know what I'm saying, or I'll be saying something and I'll look at him and he'll be like, You know what I'm saying? And that's when I know, like, I'm taking it a little too far. I have a problem with talking too much.